Woodsy, massive game, huge win. Obviously kept our finals hopes alive, never in doubt.
It's hard to say that in the first half. We just wasted opportunities and they probably scored 7 or 8 goals from turnovers. So when you're doing that, and that, you know, it makes it hard. You know, turnovers in the middle of the ground go straight back for goals. So it was disappointing in the first half, but to the boys' credit, we rallied, and I think they only scored 3 goals in the second half, which you know, is good for a team that scored over 120 points in the last 2 weeks. So, there's some good things to come out of it, but definitely need to work a bit harder going into, you know, hopefully a finals campaign.
And what was your role for the game? Who were you on for most of it?
Yeah, played on Gaff, so real elite sort of outside runner, and, very challenging. I was pretty chuffed there in the... buggered there in the first half, and then just had to stick to it and limit his effectiveness. He's a, you know, good outside runner and can, you know, score involvement sort of player. So did that role for the majority of the game.
And you managed to do it and get a fair bit of the ball yourself. Were you quite happy with your game in that respect?
Yeah, I know I've been working a bit harder to sort of get some offensive movement going, and sometimes it's just one of those games where you can sort of find it. And I guess that was a positive to keep him. I'm not sure how many he had, but I think his influence was very minimal. And to get some ball myself was a nice change from the last sort of month.
Another positive was that mark you took. Now, you're not someone that usually gets too far off the ground, mate, but you'd be pretty happy with that.
Off the ground or off the ground?
Well, both.
I'm a bit off. I don't know if you've seen that Richmond game, but...
I have seen the mark, yes. We'll play the replay over this.
It was nice to just get an opportunity to get up there, but it was just one of those things.
Maybe the best part about the mark was the lazy Susan hands off to Chappie.
He was loud, he called for it, so I thought I better give it to him, and it created a shot on goal, which was the main thing, and just disappointing. Licker couldn't slot it.
And the Essendon crowd tonight and this afternoon, could you guys sense them coming into the game as well as we started to get back into it? And what does that mean to the players to have them there?
Yeah, it was great. They were loud when sort of we kicked some goals and the momentum started to shift. And that's, you know, you feel that out on the ground. So for all the supporters out there who come along and really support us, it was great. And the players noticed that.
Well, Woodsy, you know Gary Ablett next week. You'd probably be the happiest man in Australia about that.
It's a hard one because I was pretty pumped when I heard he wasn't going to play the rest of the season, but then obviously disappointed for him. So we'll just go to the next best, I guess. it's a nice feeling, but they've got good depth. So the next player will be a good player, Jaeger O'Meara or someone like that. So we'll see how we go.
Well, mate, the Essendon fans are loving the way you play. Congratulations on the game.
Thanks, guys. Cheers.